Hi, I'm Lindy. We're back again, and today's topic is starting out the year strong. Yes, 2020 is almost upon us, and I know as we move forward, wherever you are in life, whether in your 20s, 30s, whatever, I'm also aware that the majority of viewers are more like 40s, 50s, and 60s. So wherever we are in life, there are a lot of things that we can and can't have. And as you get older, honestly, there are fewer things you can have. For instance, because I was married for 25 years before my divorce, I can never have a golden anniversary. I cannot stay alive long enough to be married to anyone for 50 years. And that's, you know, kind of sad. There are a lot of things that are no longer joyful in terms of memories. You know, when I think back on vacations and early holidays, there's a little bit of bittersweet in there because there's somebody in that picture who's no longer in my life. And while I'm good with that decision to, you know, be separated, be divorced, that's all good, it still kind of taints the pictures. So there are a lot of no's and nots in our lives as we age and as we progress through our years. It just makes sense that there are going to be some bad memories as well as good. So I really want to focus on starting out the year strong next year, because we can, okay? And it's not even hard to have a great year. It is intentional, though. If you don't make an effort to have a great day, a great week, a great month, and a great year, you might not. You might look back and say, ooh, you know that, and I understand bad days happen, I'm sorry, but even when you're in the middle of a bad day, you know, and is it really a bad day or is it a bad 15 minutes? Even when you're in the middle of it, you can say, okay, this is temporary, I'm going to get through this. Yes, my boss fussed at me. Okay, either dismiss it because it's over and it was deserved or it wasn't deserved. Learn what you need to learn from it. If it was deserved, then make the necessary changes. If it wasn't deserved, then be happy that, okay, there was a miscommunication. You're okay. And that's a good thing. Okay, so how do you have a great day, a great week, and a great year? One, be productive. People tell me I'm odd because I love to work. My boss loves me. I love to work. I love to be busy. I love to be productive because productive makes you feel good about yourself. It's kind of like the joke, no one likes to exercise, but everyone likes to have exercised, right? And you can do this with anything. No one likes to do the dishes, but everyone likes to have the dishes done. But you feel great having exercised, having done the dishes, having finished your work. So go out and be as productive. Make a list to help yourself be productive. I already have my list begun for the day after Christmas. This video is being taped before the holiday. Because after Christmas, I know there's going to be a lot to do in undecorating, in cleaning, in prepping for the next season, in prepping for the new year, in studying up files so that I'm prepared for finances. That all takes effort. But as I make my list and prepare for it, I'm going to be able to knock it out of the park and feel great about myself and my situation. Focus on your successes. It's so easy when something goes wrong to beat ourselves up and to think some of that, those ugly words that people might have joked on us when we were teenagers about, you know, you're such a loser, you can't do anything right. If it weren't for, you know, bad days, you wouldn't have any days at all. And you don't need to remember that stuff. It wasn't funny then. It wasn't true then. It's not true now. Focus on the successes. Yes, you might have to go back to last month. I am still thrilled about a success I had back in October because I know that I did something well and right. And whenever I'm feeling insecure, I go, no, no, no. I did that right. I can do this right too. So hold on to your successes. Now, don't rely on them. You use your successes to encourage you for more successes, not to sit back and go, I'm fine. I was successful last month. I'm good. No, but use them. Look for security. And we find security in different ways. One of them is through the right people. If you're insecure in a friendship, if you don't feel like your friends like you as much as you like them, if you're the one who's always calling, if you don't feel like people are really putting an effort into the friendship, you may have the wrong friends. And that means cutting and replacing. It's definitely true in your relationship. If you're insecure in your relationship, you need to sit down and have a talk. Make sure that if you have a significant other at this moment, they know how you feel so that they're not insecure. I remember when I am in a relationship, I love telling the other person, you're important to me. I find you attractive. You make me laugh. Those are all really good things that they enjoy hearing. And I enjoy telling them. I want them to know how much I enjoy time with them. So make sure that your significant other feels secure. And I think you might feel more secure in your relationship because you'll have admitted, I'm really into this person. And they'll probably reciprocate and say, you know, I find you attractive too. And that's a nice thing to hear. It's always good to know. Financial, you need to be secure financially. And making those tough decisions, spend less, bring in more money, get the second job, whatever it takes, it's going to give you a better year. You're going to start out strong if you make a decision now to be better off financially. It doesn't come overnight, and we have videos on financial security and financial decisions, but you will do it. But that's a really good place. Be secure in your home situation. Is your home comforting? Do you enjoy walking in your house, or is it cluttered and unorganized and you can't find anything? If that's your situation, this is a great time to make a decision to say, I am going to do it. I'm going to tackle one space in my house. Maybe your bedside table. Maybe it's just always cluttered. Maybe it's a kitchen drawer. Whatever the space is, it feels so good to open that drawer the next day and go, look at this. This is great. That happened to me. I was baking last night. And just last week when I was baking, I cleaned out, you know, just wiped down some spaces within the drawer. And when I opened it last night, I went, oh, this is just lovely to see it just wiped down. Minor. It took me 5 minutes. 5 minutes of your life is worth hours of joy later. So we want to start the year strong. So get organized, get cleaned up, find the right friends, do whatever it takes to make sure that your life is going to be great in 2020, and do it with a great attitude. If you do it with anger or resentment, it's not going to be a great year, but you can do this because your past is over, but your future is waiting. I'm Lindy.